Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Babita and in this video, I will teach you a quick way to remember the actions of the extraocular muscles. We know that there are 6 extraocular muscles that are responsible for eye movements. There are 4 recti, the medial rectus, lateral rectus, superior rectus and inferior rectus and 2 obliques, superior oblique and inferior oblique. And there are 6 uniocular eye movements that are also known as ductions. When the eye moves medially, that is towards the nose, it is called adduction. When the eye moves temporally, that is towards the ear, then it is called abduction. When the eye moves up in the superior direction, it is called elevation. Elevation is also known as supraduction or sursumduction. When the eye moves down, that is in the inferior direction, it is known as depression. Depression is also known as infraduction or dorsumduction. Torsional eye movements are intorsion and extorsion. When the superior pole of the eye rotates nasally, it is known as intorsion. Another word for intorsion is encycloduction. And when the superior pole of the eye rotates in the opposite direction, that is temporally, then it is known as extorsion. Another name for extorsion is excycloduction. So now let's talk about which extraocular muscle produces which eye movement. Medial rectus and lateral rectus are quite straightforward. As their names suggest, medial rectus moves the eye medially, so it causes adduction, and lateral rectus moves the eye laterally, so it causes abduction. Medial rectus and lateral rectus don't have any secondary or tertiary actions, which means that they do not cause any vertical or torsional movements of the eye. The most confusing muscle actions for most students are those of the superiors and the inferiors. Let's talk about vertical eye movements. Just like medial rectus and lateral rectus act according to their names, the same way superior rectus and inferior rectus also follow what their names suggest. So superior rectus causes elevation, that is it moves the eye superiorly, and inferior rectus causes depression because it moves the eye inferiorly. The obliques work opposite to their names. The way to remember this is that O stands for O, so obliques stand for opposite. Superior oblique is a depressor because the opposite of superior is inferior. Similarly, inferior oblique is an elevator because the opposite of inferior is superior. So it moves the globe superiorly. Recti work as their name suggests and obliques work opposite to their names. Coming to horizontal eye movements, that is adduction and abduction. The word to remember here is rad, R-A-D, rad. Recti are adductors. So the 2 recti, that is the superior rectus and the inferior rectus, are adductors. And the remaining muscles that are not recti, that is the obliques, the superior oblique and inferior oblique, are abductors. Lastly, let's talk about torsional movements. The word to remember here is sin, S-I-N, which means that superiors are intorters. So the 2 superiors, superior rectus and superior oblique, they cause intorsion of the eye. And the remaining 2 muscles, that is the inferior rectus and the inferior oblique, cause extorsion of the eye. How simple is that? So let's revise the actions of the 6 extraocular muscles once again. Medial rectus causes adduction. Lateral rectus causes abduction. Superior rectus causes elevation, adduction and intorsion. Inferior rectus causes depression, adduction and extorsion. Superior oblique causes depression, abduction and intorsion, while inferior oblique causes elevation, abduction and extorsion. I have a long video coming up in which I will give the explanation for why these extraocular muscles act the way they do. Because mnemonics are only meant for exams and for quick revision, you cannot become a good clinician if you don't try to understand the topics in depth. So till then, please like and share this video with your friends and colleagues if you found it useful. And please subscribe to my channel to support free education. Thank you very much.